Friends, I come to you via social network, but I can see each and every one of you in the pews in front of me. I see you over there. That's where you always sit. And you, I see you. Good morning. You know, I've often cussed social media. And how ironic that it is saving us right now with the ability to communicate. I want to start this morning with our announcements. You will all be receiving a letter this week explaining our plans for this time of uncertainty. For the next 2 weeks, I will be coming to you through Facebook, through YouTube, and through local television station, Channel 2. If you need anything, you let me know. We will get through this together. But for now, let's worship. Our first song has been a comfort to Christians for more than a century. So sit back, gather your thoughts, sing along if you'd like.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Mm-hmm. great hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father.
Words of comfort and words of hope. Will you please follow along for our call to worship? I'm going to read it slowly so that you can repeat each line as you wish. This comes from the 23rd Psalm. Loving Shepherd, you know our names. You care for us. When we face darkness and death, walk beside us. When we hunger for your love, fill us with your presence. When we are fearful, feed us at your table. May we dwell in the house of goodness and mercy all the days of our lives. Amen. Would you pray with me? Lord God, we come to you this morning unlike other Sunday mornings. We come to you through loving hearts. We come to you through minds of concern. And we come to you, Lord, with spirits of trust. Be with us this hour and in future hours as we lift you and we lift others up, knowing that you are all. You are Alpha and Omega. You are beginning and end. You were, you are, you will be. Thank you so much, God. We love you. Amen. I think it's interesting that today's scripture, according to the lectionary, is Psalm 23. I'd like to read it to you. I'm using the King James Version, which I don't often do, but the words are so lovely here. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. There are so many times when I am conducting a funeral that the family of the loved one asks me to repeat those words. We find them very comforting in time of death, in time of fear, in time of uncertainty. But friends, these words are also words to live by. They're words of giving over to God those things which we cannot control. In times like these, they're words that remind us that God goes before us, that God has our best interest, that God will be there no matter what, and that we can lie down in green pastures. We can walk beside still waters, and that God will be there every step of the way. I remember when I was preaching in Great Bend, and one of my parishioners was dying, and he was at home, and my little daughter, Hannah, went with me on this visit. And out of nowhere, she climbed up on his bed, and she said, "Don't be scared. This is when we know what Christianity's about." I'll never forget that, although she probably has. But this is why we're Christians, friends. This is why we can lie in green pastures, because we know the God that loves us. And God certainly does. And I want to remind you that there are miracles happening. Not even now, but because of now. New discoveries are being made for a vaccine. People are being lifted up. People are being served. People are being loving toward their neighbors like I don't think I've ever seen before. So my friends, do not be dismayed. We are here, and we will be here as God's people, God's children. And we will take care of one another during this uncertain time. At this time, we do our prayers of the people. And although I can't hear your prayers audibly, I want to pray a prayer that lifts up different peoples. And I will pause for you to lift up your own prayers. So would you join me, please? God, today we ask for your guidance. We ask for your comfort. And we ask for your presence in a very real way. God, at this time, we lift up those who are suffering. those who are worried about loved ones who live perhaps many miles away, we ask, Lord, that you be with our leaders, America's leaders and the world leaders, that they might work together . Lord, we ask that you be with our churches as we are called now to do what we preach about, and that is feeding the hungry, giving water to the thirsty, being with anyone in need. God, I can see the faces of this congregation, and I know that each one of us has something that we need you for. We need you. We need your arms around us. God, please hold us tightly. And now, God, we join together to pray the prayer that Jesus the Christ taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. At this time in our service, I say, would the ushers please come forward for our offering? Can't do that today. But we do ask that you continue to support our ministry. You will receive an envelope in the mail that you can put your check in, and it's self-addressed, self-stamped. So you can just put your check and send it back to us at the church. We would really appreciate that. So God, we ask that you please bless our offerings, that you would use this money in a way that helps bring your kingdom to earth. In Jesus' name, amen. So at this time, we will sing a song that usually is left for Easter, but I think we need it right now. So would you please sing, dance, at least smile, because we are Easter people. And I want you to imagine that we are together as a congregation, holding hands and singing our final song, Alleluia. We sing in God's Spirit. Alleluia. 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 And now, go forth. Stay strong. Be courageous. God is with us.